welcome to the laboratory of Team Echidna, where we've been investigating some of life's most intriguing questions. Did you ever wonder how an ant colony makes decisions? Or how a cell knows when to divide? Or how does this little bacterium decide whether to keep swimming or turn around? It's due to the fundamental principle of cooperativity, and we're the first group to use this principle to build better molecular beacons. A molecular beacon is a biosensor that is designed and built from a length of DNA. When it binds to a DNA signal, it unfolds and emits light. This type of beacon can help identify pathogenic organisms, viruses, even mutations. But because there are so many different noisy signals in the environment, the degree of sensitivity required can sometimes lead to false positives. So how does nature overcome problems like these? How have biological systems evolved to turn these complex environmental signals into simple binary outputs?
Observe these remarkable ants. The decision that the colony must make is whether or not to move to a new nest. This is, of course, a binary decision, but it's informed by many complex environmental signals. If ants acted non-cooperatively, each ant would make decisions independently of the other ants in the colony. This means that some ants may elect to leave while others would remain. But ants tend to behave cooperatively, meaning that each ant's decision affects its neighbors.
Do you guys smell?
Let's all cooperate.
What are you guys talking about?
The more ants decide they want to move, the more influence this will have over the rest of the colony. Ultimately, the ants will either stay or move as a group.
This cooperativity is based around the fact that the state of each subunit can affect the state of its neighboring subunits. This is a principle seen at all scales in nature, such as in the regulation of cell division, or in the proteins of the bacterial flagella motor. In fact, it was this flagella motor that provided our team with the inspiration for our design. Our team has used DNA origami to construct a brand new kind of beacon. Individual molecular beacons are joined together in a ring and connected with linking bands, so that when one of them binds a signal, its neighbors are more likely to also bind a signal. By adjusting the length of the linking bands and the signal threshold, it's possible to fine-tune both the cooperativity and sensitivity of the biosensor. In addition, we've developed mathematical models of these parameters, which allow us to feed back into the design and adapt the sensor to suit many applications, with high sensitivity and low false positives. Coupled with an amplification system and a cheap, simple detection device, this could replace slower, more expensive detection systems in developing nations and health crises. By drawing inspiration from nature, our team has not only designed a novel biosensor with many potential applications, but our results may also shed some light on some of nature's fundamental principles.